I'm Leonie Grandpierre, and I'm the head of science at Equalture. In this video, I'm going to talk to you about personality tests. They're a popular method to determine whether a candidate is a good fit with an organization and its culture. But can they actually predict whether someone is going to perform well at their job? There's many different types of personality assessments out there with big differences in the quality of their scientific foundation. Research looking into how predictive they are of future job performance show that even the ones with a solid scientific foundation, like the Big Five personality traits, for example, show only low to moderate correlations with job performance. In fact, personality assessments only show validity coefficients for predicting job performance of around 0.2, which is considered quite low. In contrast, other methods like cognitive ability tests show validity coefficients of around 0.6 when predicting job performance. To quote one of the researchers looking into this, if you took all the Big Five, measured well, and corrected for everything using the most optimistic corrections you could possibly get, you could account for about 15% of the variance in performance. So we can see that personality assessments don't seem to be great predictors for job performance. Let's now dive deeper into why that could be. First of all, many personality tests come in the form of self-assessments, which makes it really easy to fake responses. Imagine being presented with an item like, do you prefer familiarity over unfamiliarity in a job application process? You may start to think about what would be the most socially desirable way to answer this question instead of what you're actually thinking. Research shows that especially in high-stakes situations like a hiring setting, people are much more likely to give socially desirable answers to personality questionnaires. Secondly, the terminology used in personality assessments can also have a big impact on the results. Questionnaire items are often phrased vaguely, which can lead to people interpreting them differently from what was intended by the author. Especially cultural differences can lead to different interpretations of these questions and can strongly influence the results of tests like these. And finally, the explanation of results are often overly broad and may lead to the impression that they fit a particular person very well. However, in reality, these statements could apply to anyone. This phenomenon is known as the Barnum effect. These kind of results are usually too generalized to apply in a hiring setting. Especially those personality assessments that classify people into binary groups, such as being either introverted or extroverted, can lead to oversimplified interpretations of the results. They often provide no accurate interpretations for people scoring in the middle of this classification, even though this is where the majority of the population would score. Forcing a split into just two categories for a trait that should be considered a continuum results in inaccurate interpretations for most of the test takers. To wrap it up, personality assessments can be intriguing to use since they seem to provide insights into your candidates and only take a short time to complete. However, it's important to be cautious when using them in your pre-employment screening, since they have such a low validity in predicting job performance. As we discussed, this could be because of social desirability effects in the answers, vague phrasings of questions and items, and oversimplified methods of presenting the results. For a detailed case study and a more in-depth explanation of the subject, please check out our blog post that is linked below the video. Thanks for watching our video. If you want to learn more, head to our website at equalture.com. We have lots more resources and information available there. And subscribe to our channel if you want to get updates on new content like this one. See you next time.